While we're on the subject of the Botanical Garden, did you know that the Great Depression led to the creation of the garden? In the darkest days of the Great Depression, the U.S. government stepped in to assist the needy and get the economy started again. One of the most successful New Deal measures was the Works Progress Administration. This group provided more than $10 billion in federal funds from 1935 through the early 1940s. It employed millions of people in hundreds of thousands of jobs. One of those jobs was the creation of Norfolk Botanical Garden. Recently, the workers who cleared and planted the original garden were honored in a dedication ceremony of the new WPA Memorial Garden. Norfolk's Neighborhood Network was on the scene for this special historical event.
Gladys D. James.
It's a very touching time for me because I can remember my grandmother sharing with me how hard she worked and how diligent she worked out here.
Rosa L. Taylor.
And it should have been done years ago, but right now it just makes me feel so good, you know, that they're being honored and, you know, and being thought of.
They are just two of the 220 African-American men and women who in 1938 cleared 30 acres of raw land by hand and turned it into what is today the Norfolk Botanical Garden. It was part of the Works Progress Administration, a program to create jobs during the Great Depression.
The working conditions were less than ideal. Tidewater summers are hot and humid. The winters are damp and bone-chilling. The hours were long and the work physically exhausting. But when it was done, a wild and unruly landscape had been cleared of thick underbrush. Hundreds of tons of dirt had been moved to build a levee around the lake. Walking trails were carved out, and thousands of azaleas and camellias had been planted along with other shrubs and trees. And it was all done by hand for 25 cents an hour.
The only tools they used were pickaxes, hoes, rakes, pitchforks, shovels, and iron wheelbarrows.
During a recent ceremony at the garden, family members, friends, and visitors gathered to say thank you and pay tribute to the workers and the sacrifices they made.
Thank you in memory of my grandmother and everyone else who worked at WPA. Thank you for remembering them and their hard work and their labor.
Most of the original workers are all gone now, with only the memories from their family members to remind us about the work they put into the garden that we sometimes take for granted.
Today I stand here in her memory. She passed in 1970, but what she gave us was a legacy of hard work.
But remember, I said most of the original workers have passed on.
She's the most important person here today, and that is, of course, Mrs. Mary Elizabeth Ferguson, one of the original 220 WPA workers who built these gardens.
Mary Elizabeth Ferguson, Norfolk resident and soon-to-be birthday girl celebrating her 90th birthday, helped to unveil a nearly 9-foot-tall bronze statue honoring her work and the work of the 219 others who built this garden.
What was going through my mind, but Lord, you let it happen.
The sculpture we are gathered on this site to dedicate will serve as a lasting reminder to residents and visitors of the contributions made to the city by those 220 WPA workers.
I did mine work.
Most of those children were at the ceremony to celebrate the statue, the day, and the work she and others put in to create a Norfolk landmark. For Norfolk News Now, I'm John Linka.